And Jess, the other story we've been tracking in Washington there is mounting pressure on the silence coming from President Trump following that hack on a number of U.S. agencies and companies here. We had Senator Warner from Virginia earlier on this week. We were chatting with him. He seems to be attacking the president now for not acknowledging the size and scope of the latest hack.
Yeah, we did hear from Senator Warner again, echoing what he told us earlier this week. He is the top Democrat on the Senate Intel Committee, and he's saying that this shows that the White House needs to step in and say something here. We have heard that from several lawmakers. We're also hearing from lawmakers who were also briefed today, some of them who say that this shows that the president needs to sign the NDAA, which does have some cybersecurity provisions in it. They say that the U.S. does need to do more on the cybersecurity front. This is a hack that is more widespread than we originally knew. Cybersecurity officials in the U.S. have said that this poses a grave risk to the federal government. And there are reports that the agency that maintains the nuclear weapons stockpile was also compromised. So very serious clearly here. And we are starting to hear more and more from lawmakers who say the White House needs to step up.
And we've seen some gains from cybersecurity firms on the back of that as well, in the market, at least today. Jessica Smith, thanks so much for that.